Hi there, how's it going? This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video. And today we're going to be looking at one of the two Hattons Originals Class 66 00 gauge scale model. That is the Class 66 diesel locomotive. Also, another EMD locomotive that has recently joined my fleet of 00 gauge model trains, and this one is also going to be used on my model railway once that is completed. This Class 66, folks, is possibly one of the heaviest replica models that I've ever owned, and this is about roughly 750 grams. Although that's without the packaging, it's well over a kilogram according to the parcel label when it arrived to me. And this is another one of the six that came to me on my birthday in June 2021. As you know, this one is the first GBRF Class 66, and I believe this is a Euro 4. For the reasons being, it does have the extra door on the off side of the train, and the reference number for this one is H4-66-025. And at the time I bought this, folks, there was some still left available on the Hattons website, so if you want to go and get one of these, please do. I have given this a wee test run just before doing this video, okay? As you know, there's been many videos and topics about the axle boxes, as apparently this model does, and it is the only version of the Class 66 that has rotating wheel boxes. But it's easy fixes, and if I need to, I'll just do that myself, just to get this working and that, you know. But so far, I did do a wee test run and I checked the model over and none of them came away. So fingers crossed, this should be one of the good ones. But anyways, let's get started and let's crack the lid off this box. I'm gonna let the weight of the train hold it down, as although it is quite tightly packed, as you can probably tell. Excuse me, apologies for catching the camera there, folks, but I'm really looking forward to doing this review. Such a cracking model, and you'll see what I mean when we get to the close-ups and the 360 degree rotation. It's really fantastic, folks, you know. Anyways, I'm just going to pop the lid over here. Mundane stuff first, as always, folks, okay. Operating instructions. Just to declare, this is not a DCC fitted or a sound version, but I do plan to put a Zemo 6 function decoder into this when the time comes. And I may do some modifications to the handrails so that they are attached at the chassis and not the body. Never tried it before, as I've never owned one of these before. But I'm willing to try my own experiments and stuff, you know. Anyways, I'm going to quickly walk you through the instructions. I just want to get to the first page, okay? Standard contents shows you the model in X-ray view and all the other good bits and bobs about this, and the introduction and all that kind of good stuff. One thing I will say, compared to some other brands that I have experiences with, the Hattons instructions are very, very informative, very straightforward, and at least they use the correct drawings as well. So, all grand. Several options. However, folks, I haven't done any alterations, with altering these switches. These will all be in the default position as they left the factory, okay? and it will be analog mode because I do not have my controller and I don't have a decoder fitted, and I don't want to fry the circuit boards without a suitable chip, okay? But adding a decoder, it's very simple, and there's plenty of YouTube videos on how to fit a 21 pin decoder. You just gotta be careful with the detailing, as I have seen on other people's videos. And when I get around to it someday, I will do my own version of how to fit a DCC decoder, but more on that later. There's the instructions and everything, folks. So that's the mundane stuff covered. Let's pop off the foam lid, shall we? Now that is one cracking model, and I've not even got the blister packaging removed as of yet. I'll just put it back as it was, as it came to me, just to show you just how fantastic this model really is. And it's just breathtaking. At the time I've done this video, Hattons were still selling these for a pound under 120 or 119 plus postage, depending on where you are. And I can't recommend these models enough. And it will be interesting to see how these perform. It is very, very heavy, folks. And this packaging is rock solid. Really is. And there's a piece of the packaging just come away there, folks, okay? Solid foam, I'd say. Kind of reminds me of that insulation foam that they put in lofts. Although I could be wrong. And in addition to that, we do get a bit more foam as well. This is just to keep the box nice and rigid. And there is a way that you should put this in. Put the sleeve on this way, slide it over when putting it away. Otherwise, if you go this end, like I did, it'll just move it all over the place, okay? So just bear that in mind if you get one of these yourselves and you're gonna store it in the box when not in use, okay? Right, that's the packaging removed. Now what we've got here, folks, I'm just gonna place this sleeve somewhere. Before we move on to the locomotive, which I've already shown you briefly, you are presented and supplied with a flush air dam and a non-flush air dam. So if you want to put a coupling at the other end, which is this is they class as the leading end nearest the fans, although in the real world technically this is cab number 2. However, I like this formation better. So, unlike the Class 60, I will technically be running these back to front. If the camera is picking this up, folks, just check out all that detail in there. Absolutely stunning and cracking. And this is in the GBRF version of the livery, as per the one I have in my left hand, okay? And you just unbolt 2 screws once you remove the body shell. And swap them to your preferences and tastes, okay? But just look at all that detail there. And I believe there is 2 extra NEM automatic tension lock couplers too. So that will be interesting. I'm hoping there's an extra one attached to the back of this. As, to be honest, I don't want to open this bag if I can help it. At least not until I get the layout built, as I don't want to lose anything. But anyway, that's the details covered. Now just look at this, absolutely gorgeous, and I really, really cannot wait to do the close-ups on this beast. It's an absolute monster of a locomotive. Not even the Bachmann versions have this much detail or this sheer amount of weight. I dare say this is about possibly 50, if not 60%, more heavier and more heavy duty than the Bachmann version, And definitely, I'd say it's about three times the weight of the Hornby ex-Lima version. And odd now, because many years ago, I've owned the Lima version of the Class 66, because that was the first one that come out long before the Bachmann ones do. And I believe it's just the same tooling that Hornby are using. But I may do a comparison in the future, compare all three. And I do hope that Bachmann, correction, Hattons, will do another run of these, including the We Are The Future DB livery and the Powered By HVO DB livery on their version of the Class 66, as I think these would sell quite well, especially once Hattons have ironed out the bugs. If they revise the axle boxes, it wouldn't be a bother, you know. But anyways, let's get this packaging aside. And what I'm going to do, I'm just going to crack this open. I'm going to just move this packaging that's in the view off camera. I'm just going to use the lid just to rest this on and crack open the blister packet, okay? Now, for those of you that watch my Murphy Models 1-to-1 class review, right? This is what I mean by the split polyfin. It makes handling the model far much easier. I'm just making sure it's still in view, folks. And what I'm going to do, just grab it from the sides of the body and ease it out. Now, I'd say this is about possibly 750 grams. That is 3/4 of a kilogram, folks. Well, that's about 1.5 pounds imperial weight of train here. So it's about 1.5 pounds, I'd say. Just to give my friends that are in the United States and stuff. And that is just an absolute beauty. Cracking model. Sprung buffers. Got a full flush air dam at the front. And just as expected here, folks, we've got the automatic NEM coupler on the back that uses the alternative air dams, as you see here. One of my buffers, it's got a mind of its own, but nicely sprung. Cracking stuff. 66731, this one is. And I'm just going to rest that on the box just for now, folks, okay? So, just to tick all the boxes, I've covered the model, covered the detail parts, instructions, packaging, and give my first impressions on this model. And the next thing for me to do is to cut the video, put this on the turntable, and then move on to the fun part. And I'm really looking forward to this, folks. And that is the close-ups and then the 360 degree rotation. Okay. As you can probably tell, folks, I'm really, really looking forward to doing this part of this review. And that is just one cracking model. From my observations and from what I've read on posts and stuff, there's at least 100 differently fitted parts, as the brake pipes, sandpipes, steps, the handrails, buffer beam detail, even the wee footsteps at the front of this train. They're all separately fitted, and for that amount of detail, you can't find a model with this much detail. And to be honest, folks, this Hattons Originals Class 66 is heavier than the Hornby Class 60, so it'll be interesting to see the torque and the haulage capabilities that this model has to offer, you know. But detail very much speaks for itself. And to be honest, I think it's time before I get too carried away with observing this model just with my own eyes. It's just breathtaking. And I'm going to be truthful. Before we move on to the rotations, when the Class 66s first arrived into the UK, folks, when I was living in England until 2017, I didn't like Class 66s at all. I was more into the British Rail traction. But Class 66s now, they are beginning to grow on me. Because although they're common, and they are commonly used on a lot of work on freights, because they're not really suitable for passenger any more than the Class 60s were, because they have no head end power or a power pack to power coaches and stuff. Hence the name Shed. They were kind of more or less like a souped up Class 59 in my opinion, and I was more into things like the Class 60, Class 56, Class 58s, Class 37s. And don't get me wrong, folks, I will always love those trains, as they do have their own unique characteristics, just like the HSTs. But you know, times come and go, and there is never a forever thing. But anyway, keeping on topic with this fantastic model, right? Just look at all that detail, and let's just take this camera and let's have a good close look at it. As you can see there, separately fitted radiator grills on the roof, and these grills are also transparent, but unlike the Class 60 and the GM121 classes that I've covered in previous videos, there's nothing to see through, although the grills are kind of see through when the body shell is removed, from what I've observed on other people's YouTube videos on these fantastic models from Hattons. And Hattons are onto a winner with this one, folks. It's just a shame about the bugs with some of them, you know. Sprung buffers, which I did briefly show you in the introduction. Very many, possibly 100 detail parts in total, as these do have interiors in the cabs as well, just like the Hornby Class 66. I do believe these handrails on the cab doors could be metal, as they didn't flex when I handled the model earlier. And this one is the first GBRF, or Great Britain Rail Freight. Just to correct myself quickly there, folks. Got the orange wrap around the windscreen and the first group bands on the yellow front end as well. And this has the newer, as this version I think is a Euro 4. As these locomotives, I think they entered service with GBRF around 2006, 2007. And this one is numbered as 66731. Absolutely cracking detail, and you will see this in the test run, of which I'm looking forward to doing, folks. But anyways, just to help you navigate around this potentially long video, I will be putting the timestamps in the video description. Very nice and crisp livery and fleet names and fleet number applications. And just something else as well, folks, from what I've learned from other people's videos that have owned these models before me, the windows are separately fitted as well, so it's not part of the body shell, unlike some of the other models, and they are quite fragile, and there's only certain parts, definitely not the bogies or the gas tanks underneath, as some people have removed the body shell by handling the gas tank and that's definitely not what I'm going to do when I put a DCC decoder into this. And I will use a cocktail stick just to remove the handrails. Or what I might do, I might modify the handrails on the bottom, the grab irons to where the first step is, and I may trim them and fix them into the chassis. So when it makes removing the body shell in the future for maintenance and stuff, I'm not going to risk breaking those very fragile parts. So I may have a go at doing a mod for those. If they're plastic, I may replace them with metal ones. But if they're metal, then they should be okay. But I'm not entirely sure. But anyways, just look at that. You got the radio pod up there. Got the roof exhaust pod there. This version is a Euro 5, and you will see this in the rotation, okay, folks? And you've also got the fan grills and the radiators, as this is technically the back end of the train, as cab number one is facing away from us. But I'm going to be running this one in this setup because I just like this position better, to be honest, folks. A bit like with the Class 6s. But anyways, I think we've covered everything, and I've let the detail very much speak for itself. So what I'm going to do, folks, I'm going to cut the video here, and then we're going to move on to the 360 degree rotation. And to be honest, I'm really looking forward to this, especially the performance test. Okay, folks, it's now time to do the fun part. Before the real fun begins, there will be with the performance test. And what I'm going to do, because this is quite a long engine, folks, just as long as the Class 60, I'm going to zoom out, and I'm hoping that will be enough to allow me to do this 360 degree rotation, folks. Just going to tilt the camera slightly to the right, okay? Absolutely cracking livery, and I'm looking forward to showing you the extra detail on the other side, because this, folks, is a Euro 4 version of the Class 66, hence the extra engine room door. And I believe this one could be a 2006-2007 locomotive when it was new to GBRF at the time of trading as First GBRF. Although I believe another company now runs GBRF, if I'm not mistaken. Just look at that beautiful texturing. Very crisp livery application. There's no fuzz or blurring from what I can see on this, folks. And as we come to the offside, we have got etched grills all round. This is a model that would, with detail, that I've only seen on continental models, such as the Fleischmann and the Sud Express Euro 4000, of which I do have one of those in the Euro Porte livery, but that'll come in the future, as I've had that model for over a year, but I'm still repairing it. But sticking on topic, just look at this cracking detail. It's absolutely mind-blowing, and this camera just doesn't do this model justice. And £119 plus postage, it's cheaper than Bachmann. It's only slightly more than the Hornby models, and to be honest, it's worth every penny. But anyways, that's the rotation done, folks, and I'm definitely impressed, very impressed, and I'm really trying to contain my excitement of doing the performance test on this train, to be honest. Anyway, folks, that's all for the close-ups and the rotation, okay? So the next thing for me to do is to pop this onto the test track. It will be the same train as what I've done with the Class 60s and others, as I'm in the process of getting some super detailed wagons to go with these cracking models, you know. But more on that later. Let's get to the test run, shall we? Right, folks, it's now time to move on to the ultimate fun part of this review. And this is the performance test of the Hattons Originals Class 66. And to be honest, I'd never expected that I would be virtually taken back by a model of a Class 66, of which only very recently they've begun to grow on me. As, to be honest, when they first come to the tracks back in the late 1990s to early 2000s, I wasn't really interested in them. And to be honest, I didn't really find them very appealing. But this model has actually changed all of that. And to be honest, Class 66s are not bad locomotives. They're very reliable and they do have a bit of a 1980s look to them because they are based on the Class 59. But anyway, folks, I've got the background train running that is a GWR HST Castle class, which uses my limited edition pike. So I thought that'd be a nice contrast, and let's get to the test run then. As I said before, I'm using the default light setup. I'm not sure how this train will handle or if I will lose any axle boxes, but if I do, it's not a real deal breaker. If I can find them, I'll just reattach them back to the model with a wee drop of super glue. But very smooth. And I'm just using my default Coca-Cola train here, folks, just to give it a load to haul. But I'd think and I'd imagine, this train being relatively heavyweight, those wagons will probably be light as a feather to it, you know. But this is a GBRF version of 66731. And it does have the newer LED headlights rather than the, what I'd call the bug-eyed lights, like on the other version of this model, which I'm going to get in the future. But I will be getting an EWS version and a DB cargo version if I can track one down. As sadly, those models at Hattons are sold out. And to be honest, of all the horror stories I've been hearing on YouTube and all that kind of stuff about parts coming off and having to repair them themselves, I was a bit reluctant upon hearing them stories of getting one of these, but I'm glad I did. And to be honest, I can fully understand why the Freightliner and the EWS and the DB versions, along with that very nice Biffer GBRF Class 66, they've sold really quickly and they've completely sold out. Because at a price of £119, when these were first released, they were £150. You do get a lot of detail in return for the price, and to be honest, this is the first proper run it's actually had. I just did a quick test just before doing the video, folks, and I will do that with all my model trains from now on, because when I did a video before in the past, One of the model trains didn't work. There wasn't any of these in this six that I got for my birthday. This was about 2 years ago, and the model train didn't work. And I had to scrap the whole video because I couldn't get that train to run. And it wasn't an easy fix either. So just as a precaution, folks, I will now do tests to make sure the model train works and it's fully functioning before I commence on with committing to doing a review, because there's nothing more frustrating than doing the close-ups, doing the rotation and doing the introduction only to find that the model doesn't work, you know, and it's quite frustrating. But I'm well pleased with this model, and I do have another one, so hopefully, fingers crossed, the other model that I will cover later on will just be as good as this one, folks. I believe the tail lights are turned on by default on DC mode on the Class 66, but we will find out very soon once I turn the camera around. Okay, as you know, I like to do thorough performance tests, and this is just an amazing model. It's also cheaper than the Bachmann Class 66, and it's also cheaper than the Hornby Class 60, and heavier too. So you get a lot of weight on this model, and it's possibly one of the heaviest UK model trains that I own. A second to that is the Hornby Class 60, as they pack a lot of weight, but this one is the king of the heavies. Anyway, I'll have a couple of more passes, folks. It'll be time to switch over and show you the tail lights, okay? As you can just see there, folks, the model does have the tail lights turned on by default on DC mode. However, they're not too bright. They're just at the right ambient to the prototype locomotives. Although, without removing the body shell to turn them off, which I've left them on just for the benefit of this video, but on DCC, you can turn them off with a function key. So if you've got a DCC fitted, or the sound version, you can just press a function and that'll just turn them off. And the model does have working cab lights for the DCC sound decoder version. However, cab lights are not normally used, or they should not be used when the train is moving. So it's not really a deal breaker for me, but it's nice to know that the model does have cab lights that are function operated. So if you had a load of these parked up in your traction maintenance depot, that'd be the place where the cab lights would likely be turned on at night. But when they're moving, they're not normally on, and they shouldn't really be on when the train is moving on the main line anyways. Anyway, folks, I do hope you are enjoying this performance test. It's very smooth. It's a very silent runner. There is no obvious grinding noises or anything like that that I've had with a couple of the Bachmann Class 66s I've owned in the past. And to be honest, this is one of the models that is okay. But as I said, if an axle box comes away after it being ran for a considerable amount of time, I will fit it back on. But there is no bouncing on this version that I have, so I'm going to count myself lucky. And maybe this is one of the later releases with the corrections, I don't know. But I have read reports and seen videos of reports of where other people have had problems with their models that wobble and bounce like a pacer. Thankfully, that's not happened with mine. And I hope that the second model that I got for my birthday back in June 2021 won't have that problem either. But if it does, I will correct that. But I will run the model in the test run of the review just to show off the handling and stuff, you know. Okay. But all in all, it's a very nice model. And I can now see why these are very popular. All-wheel drive, 21-pin DCC, various light functions and configurations via the switches inside. And you can turn off the tail lights under DCC. And you can on DC mode, but you will have to use the switches. And that's all covered in the manual. Although at the moment, I don't have any named Class 66s from Hattons. However, I do intend getting one of the named examples just to see how good the nameplates and stuff are. But I took a chance, as I'm not really a risk taker, and to be honest, things like loose parts coming away on models and reports of that kind of stuff, it kind of put me off and it delayed me getting one of these. But if I do get a model like that in the future, I'll just repair it myself. One, it gives me something to do. I know it should be happening with new release models, as these models are not cheap. I get that. But rather than go through the hassle of sending the model back or sending it away for the manufacturer or the store to fit new parts on it, if I have the parts on me, I'll fit them myself, as it saves all the hassle, you know. Anyways, I've been talking to you for quite a bit now, and I think it's time to wrap up this review, don't you think, folks? As we have been talking for a while now, and I did warn that this video might be long, because this is one impressive model. Anyway, one more pass, and I will cut the video as soon as the filming zone is clear, okay? Well, folks, I think it's time to start winding down and to bring this review to a close. On this occasion, I don't know how the other review will turn out, as I haven't covered the other model as of yet. My experience with the Hattons Class 66 on this occasion has to be a positive one, and I think this one could be a later release. And thankfully, and as far as I know, I'm assuming all the axle boxes are still on the model, but I will check the track for anything missing, and I will check the model over before I put it away back in its box, as once I've done all the 6 reviews of the model trains that I got for my birthday in June 2021, at the time this video is done, all reviews will use this track, as then I can focus on doing the model train railway, well, Bloomfield Lee Road. My verdict on this model, if you want to get one just to see what they're like, to be honest, compared to the asking prices of the Hornby Class 60 and the Bachmann Class 66s, £119 for one of these models is a bargain, and I have to totally agree with the statement of bargain on the Hattons website of where these are available. Detail, possibly some of the best I've ever seen on any Class 66 model in 00 gauge. Performance, central can motor, 5-pole, all-wheel drive, rotating axle boxes. Now that's a first on any model train I've owned, as I've not seen that on any diesel locomotive before. Weight and traction and torque, all there. Excellent performance all round. Handling is good. The motor is very silent. The model does come with NEM couplers, all-wheel drive, central cam motor, working cab lights on DC C mode with the sound decoder, which is another option for this one. Several fitted separately applied parts, as where most of them on the Hornby model are pre-molded, as it is ex-Lima, and this one only costs about £30 to £40 more than the Hornby version. So if you want one, get them while you still can, folks, as to be honest, I have been in touch with Hattons to see if they will produce another run of these, and there are no plans to at the moment, at the time this video was made. Whether that will change in the future or not, I don't know. But detail, performance, handling, features, accuracy, I think this model has earned itself a perfect 10 out of 10 on the example that I own. As for a shed, of which is what they're nicknamed as, although the real things are maybe nothing special, but this model, it just raises the bar of super detailing to another level. And it could change the game on the Bachmann versions in the future, who knows. But would I get another Hattons Class 66? Sure. Would I recommend it? It's up to you. Personally, if you want something modern and you do modern era on your UK freight scene, I'd definitely recommend one. Without a doubt. In terms of the price, performance, detail, quality, I'd give this a perfect 10 out of 10. Without a second sport. And that, folks, that concludes this review of the Hattons Originals Class 66 diesel locomotive, of which this one is the Euro 4 in the First GBRF livery. That is 66731. And that concludes this video. If you made it this far, big thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like, just so that more people will discover this cracking model from Hattons. And if you enjoyed the video as well, please tell me your thoughts on the Hattons Class 66. And let me know your thoughts on these models. Let me know your experiences. Good, bad, neutral. It's all out there to be discussed, folks, you know. From this experience, I've had a good experience with the Hattons Class 66, but it may not be the case for you, you know. So I'd be interested in, if you own any of these models of the Hattons Class 66, of any version, I'd be interested to know what your experiences are with these models. But for me, I'd have no problems in buying another one, and I definitely intend to. Anyway, folks, let's wrap this video up, okay? As it's getting long, and I don't want to go on too much, as I've just about covered everything. So I think it's time to wrap it up here, folks. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in another video coming soon. Okay? Anyways, take care of yourselves. All the best. Look after each other. Look after yourselves. Enjoy model railways. And stay tuned for the next one. Cheerio, folks. And all the best.